Babita Angle Prabhudesai. I'm the president of Madgaon IMA branch and a pathologist by profession. And today we have with us a very well-known gynecologist from Margao, Dr. Brennan Tavarish, who has been in the entire second wave of COVID. He has been doing a lot of work for the community and for his patients, and also guiding us throughout the throughout this phase of COVID. So in fact, today we are here, and it's a humble effort on the part of Madgaon IMA to educate its people and the viewers about post-COVID complications. Now that we are sort of coming out of this second wave of COVID, the numbers are going down. There have been an equally challenging time now, you know, handling post-COVID complications. And that is why today I am with Dr. Brennan, so that he talks about post-COVID issues in pregnancy, so that we educate our viewers as how to handle it and to know about it, to make them aware of it. So, Brennan, can I ask you one thing? What are the common post-COVID complications that you see in pregnant women? My second question would be, what you can, what message would you like to give to these pregnant women so that, you know, they can take care at home and be aware of if there is any problem? So, first of all, people should be aware that these problems are existing, you know.
As far as pregnancy is concerned, there are two things what we would, on two aspects we would like to follow these patients. One would be effects on the mother, and the second one would be what would be the effects on the baby and the baby's growth. Now, coming to the mother, as we all know that most of the times COVID is usually mild in pregnant patients. But however, if the patient becomes symptomatic, that means if she has got fever, these pregnant patients are more likely to develop a very severe disease as compared to if they were not pregnant at that age. So they are more likely to be admitted in the ICU, they are more likely to be requiring a ventilator or a device requiring oxygen. They do recover fast, but you need to pick them fast. So my first message to them would be, do not hide your illness or do not be under a negative impression that you do not have COVID and it will be some other viral infection. Please report to your concerning doctor as early as possible if you have got any of the signs, whether you have got fever, common cold, body ache, throat pain, loose motions. Do not ignore. Let it be a false alarm, but let your doctor decide that it's a false alarm. It's not up to you to decide. Your duty is only to report with the symptoms. Now, as far as once COVID is over, the patient recovers. These patients, usually post-COVID, we are usually worried about, you know, the inflammation being continued for long and the lungs being involved. And in pregnant patient, as the baby grows, we all know that as the abdomen grows,
the lung capacity.
Yeah, the lung capacity reduces and the patient's ability to tolerate deep breaths becomes less.
Yes.
So as a result, she becomes more and more breathless.
Because as it is, they are breathless.
Yes. So it is important that they, you know, do a lot of breathing exercises, report to the physicians. It should be a joint
effort
of both the obstetrician as well as the pulmonologist to teach them breathing exercises so that that tolerance in the 8th month and 9th month to the growth of the baby and breathing problems becomes much lower. As far as the baby is concerned, we have seen that the virus does not cause abnormalities in the baby because the chance of the virus passing through the placenta is very, very less. But there are possibilities that the placenta itself will be infected more often than the baby. So as a result, the blood flow to the baby becomes less, the growth of the baby can become less, and the water levels tend to reduce.
So in other words, you have smaller babies.
Smaller, chances of smaller babies are less, chances of early delivery are less. So my advice to them would be...
Early deliveries are more.
Yes, I mean early deliveries are more.
And the chances of smaller babies are more.
So what I would advise them is follow up frequently, more frequently after you recover, after 15 days, with your doctor, and please listen to your doctor's advice, because it's not that, you know, the COVID doesn't affect the pregnancy afterwards. it can cause, we have seen that, you know, water levels reduced to quite a substantial fraction even in the third trimester. Third trimester means the last 3 months. So the growth of the baby is extremely important. It is important to monitor these pregnancies from both mother's aspects as well as the baby's aspects, because our aim at the end of the day is to have a healthy mother and a healthy baby.
Okay, the next is the neonate.
Yeah.
You know, what suppose we have a post-COVID mother and a neonate, what care would you, what message would you give to our young mothers, you know, who have just delivered, and if when they were COVID, as far as breastfeeding
is concerned.
Lactation is concerned.
Yeah, now people are under the impression that if you have got COVID and you have just delivered, you should not breastfeed. Absolutely no. Breastfeeding is very safe, and breast milk should be the feed of choice to all these babies who are born of COVID positive mothers. The mothers can take special precautions in the sense that they should be wearing a mask, a face shield, they should sanitize their hands well, wash their hands before feeding, and just wipe the nipple nicely with water before feeding. Feeding techniques are the same. Only thing is, avoid coughing as far as possible with the neonate in hand. And once you have breastfed, you keep the baby probably at a distance of 2 meters from your bed. So keep the cradle a little bit far away from the bed. Very few babies require separation, and those babies would be premature babies, or if babies have got additional comorbidity, like if they are diabetic themselves, or if the mother is really, really frightened and she feels she cannot handle the baby, then it would be reasonable to separate them. But I would not advise to separate them.
By and large, no.
And no, separation is not required. Breast milk, even in separated babies, breast milk is the feed of choice. You only express it in the container, hand it over to an intermediary who is likely to follow the same sanitization protocols so that it is safe for the baby. See, at the end of the day, our aim is to see that the baby does not get COVID, which is transmitted postnatally either through the mother or through the healthcare worker or through the intermediary who is feeding the baby. But yes, breast milk is the feed of choice in all these cases.
Would you recommend a test on a newborn, you know, who is born to a COVID mother?
All babies should be tested, and the test, ideally what the guidelines follow is, one test should be done at 24 hours. It should be a RT-PCR from the nasopharynx or the oropharynx, and if that test is negative, a second test at 48 hours. But in a country like India, where resources are not readily available and labs are already overburdened with so many cases, it would be advisable to do an RT-PCR as close to discharge as possible as a single test if you want to do only one test.
Dr. Brennan, another question is, there is a lot of myth, or there are a lot of questions that are asked to us, whether is it safe for a pregnant patient to take vaccine, or a person who is breastfeeding to take vaccine.
Yeah.
So I think we need to clear this myth and give a very clear-cut message to our viewers and to public at large.
Yes. Now, regarding breastfeeding and vaccination, America and Europe were the first countries to tell us that breastfeeding and vaccination can go hand in hand, and every breastfeeding mother should be given a vaccine. It is their right, but they have to have adequate information regarding which vaccines they are taking. Now, in America, they have the mRNA vaccine, that is the Pfizer vaccine and the Moderna vaccine, and they very well found out that as early as 15 days after the vaccination, they have managed to detect good amount of antibodies which are protective and neutralizing, which will give the benefit to the baby and would be beneficial for the newborn. Now, in India, Covaxin and Covishield at present, the Covishield vaccine is the same as the AstraZeneca Oxford vaccine, which is developed by the Serum Institute and which has been used to a vast extent in Europe to vaccinate pregnant as well as breastfeeding mothers. Now, how does these two vaccines differ is that breastfeeding and pregnant people are the younger generation, who are relatively younger, below the age group of 40. So there is a slight rare complication of blood clots between because of the vaccination. Vaccination induced blood clots with Covishield, which is a viral vector vaccine. But that is so rare, it is just 1 in 1,000,000 doses. 1 in 1,000,000 means it's quite rare.
Yeah, so I think that is what has scared people when they
So people are frightened with respect to taking a Covishield. But remember that that event is
so rare.
Rarer than you meeting with an accident on a bicycle, on a bike or in a car. But we don't stop driving a car or a bicycle,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So the fear of blood clots, which is a very, very rare event, should not
stop people
from basically taking the vaccine, and they should be benefited. Because we have seen that people who have taken the vaccine, even in this mutant strain, by far and large, they have had a very, very mild disease. They have had rare instances of this, but that does not mean that one case is sufficient enough to say that vaccination drive is bad.
Exactly.
So I would advise all breastfeeding mothers, please log on to your Cowin portal, register yourself, get a date, and just benefit you and the baby
Brennan,
from the vaccination.
I think this is this vaccination among the lactating mothers, among the pregnant women, is also probably going to prepare us for the third wave, which the experts are sort of forcing or anticipating.
Coming to pregnancy. Pregnant patients also can take the vaccine, but I would advise them that the Government of India guidelines have not yet included pregnant patients, though they have started lactating mothers right now. Register and keep, and the second trimester means after 4 months would be the ideal time to take the vaccine.
So once the guidelines come.
Yes. So I would advise the patients to vaccinate themselves in the second trimester. Once the government clears pregnant patients for vaccination in India.
Take home message for the pregnant women is, if they are found to be COVID positive, do not hide it. Please report to your doctor or to your concerned obstetrician or gynecologist immediately. Secondly, post COVID, don't think that you have come out of it and everything is good now. No, you frequent your gynecologist more often, so that you know a proper chart of your growth, of the baby's weight, you know how you're gaining weight is maintained completely, because we have seen a lot of post-COVID issues like the fluid in the sac decreases or the baby is not growing properly. So be aware of this. So the whole idea of this talk with Dr. Brennan is to make people aware, so that you know we do not have complications.
And one important point to those people who have not yet got COVID, the pregnant patients, please do not let your guard come down, especially when you are in your last 3 months of pregnancy, because this is the time where COVID has its maximum danger in the last 3 months. So do not venture out unnecessarily. Please wear your mask, wear a face shield, wear gloves when you're going out, keep safe distance. And prevention is the only way where you can secure yourself.
So the second take-home message would be, breastfeeding is not contraindicatory, or it's not contraindicated if the mother is COVID positive. In fact, breastfeeding is very good by maintaining proper protocols. Next is for the lactating mothers, vaccine is very, very safe. It has already been, the lactating mothers have already come into the, vaccine for them has already come into the guidelines of the Government of India. And so I request everybody to please get yourself vaccinated once again, and to still, even despite vaccination, to maintain all the other COVID appropriate behavior. So Dr. Brennan, thank you so much for your time today and for enlightening our viewers about what is to be done and you know how to make the pregnant and the lactating mothers
most
aware.
Welcome, Dr. Babita.
I hope the public do
take our advice and do not hesitate. The hesitancy of this has led to a lot of morbidity, and seek proper information from medical people and not WhatsApp and friends' messages.
Thank you so much, Dr.